Welcome to today's edition of the show podcast.
After last week's promo, we all knew that Thursday's Grey's Anatomy would be bringing back Chyler Leigh as the late, lamented Lexie Grey. The question was, would she be sending Meredith forth, as in getting her off that damn beach already and returning her to her family and friends? Read on and, if you don't know by now, find out. We are down to our last four ventilators. As Breathe began, Mare was joined on the beach by Lexie. Meanwhile, in reality, Maggie, Mama Ortiz and Levi treated Marcella, whose daughter Veronica was also at Grey Sloan suffering from the effects of COVID. Nearby, Joe continued to bond with Luna and tended to Irene, Cormac's sister-in-law, who was both at high risk for coronavirus owing to her MS and, as an added bonus, had a kidney stone. Maggie was feeling some pre-separation anxiety over the fact that Winston was due back in Boston. And finally, Richard reported to Team Grey Sloan that they only had four ventilators left, so they were all going to have to think creatively. Did they ever not? Back on the beach, Lexie asked Mare if she was going to remain on the beach. It takes some getting used to, Lexie admitted. And just as she copped to having loved rules, Mark showed up to affirm that oh yeah, she had. There was some more talk about the sand not having been real. Then Mare confirmed that on her beach, the star-crossed lovers got to be together in the end. I like it here, Grey said. We could see why. Mark told Mare that he often yelled as best he could at his loved ones to wake up, not waste a moment. Then he gave them credit for coming up with the idea. Later, Lexie challenged Mare to find things, even in a pandemic, to enjoy. And what did she savor? Stuff like little Bailey face-planting in his birthday cake and Zola laughing so hard at it that she peed her pants. That is impolite adult conversation, back up and at M, Tom crossed paths with Owen. At the same time, Teddy brought Leo and Allison to Mare's, where Amelia suggested that they could have tea and not be covered in puke for an afternoon. Watching the kids, Amelia added that Teddy's grief over DeLuca might ease if she shared it. In turn, Teddy asked if there was a recovery program for people who aren't addicts who still blew up their lives. At the hospital, Owen texted with Christina, who insisted on receiving a photo of Mare's monitors. And, after Link scrubbed in with Richard, Weber pitched a fit because they were now down to their last damn ventilator, they'd have to shut down the trauma unit. Yep, it was a zippy episode. This is not a catastrophe, it's a complication. After ascertaining Irene's condition, Cormac floated the idea of having Catherine scrub in. His kids had already lost their mother, he didn't want them losing their aunt too. He pulled the biggest strings, Catherine said after showing up. Irene was worried that her treatment would go the way of her late sisters. But Catherine assured her that she wasn't just in good hands, she was in the best ones, hers. As Irene was wheeled into surgery, she teased Cormac about Mare, until she found out that Grey was in dire straits. Operating on Irene, Catherine encouraged Joe to consider urology. Just as they were finishing up, they discovered that Irene was far worse off than they thought, her ureter came out with the kidney stone.